What do you want? What's the number one question that you say she needs to answer?
Well, there's two key cases to start with. In the Sanchez case, she ruled that the Second Amendment was not a fundamental core right. The other big case, the Maloney case, she ruled that it didn't apply to individuals everywhere. So these questions need to be asked. And I'll tell you this from the NRA, because we're going to stand unflinchingly for the Second Amendment. If she is evasive, if she does not unequivocally support the Second Amendment, we will oppose this nomination. You know, the American public overwhelmingly favors this freedom. They know it's a core fundamental right. I mean, the Second Amendment, my gosh, it has more reason than any other freedom to apply to every citizen of the country. I mean, going back to King George, when the founding fathers wanted this country never to live under that type of oppression again. They wrote the Second Amendment into the Bill of Rights. After the Civil War, when they started enacting the Black Codes to say that freed slaves couldn't preach and be educated and travel and have the right to own a firearm to protect themselves from the Klan, Congress stepped in and not only passed the 14th Amendment, but the Freedmen's Act, saying every American has the right to own a firearm. After World War II, they passed the, when they were requisitioning property for World War II, they said you couldn't go into people's home and take their firearms because it was an individual constitutional right. So the Second Amendment has not only a textual context, but it also has the unequivocal support of a co-equal branch of government as an individual right.
Would you, I mean... Wayne, would you say, I'm sorry to interrupt you, would you say that, our president or our government's stock market really is gun sales? That when gun sales go down, I mean, everybody wants to say, oh, well, I protect guns for hunters. You know what? I mean, look, I came from a family of hunters. I get it. But that's not, the founding fathers weren't like, well, we might want to go out and, you know, shoot some squirrel. They did it because of an out-of-control government. And as gun sales go up, that's because we don't trust the government. That is the fundamental guttural understanding of the Second Amendment. People don't trust the government, they go out and buy a gun. And when we trust the government, gun sales will go down. Agree or disagree?
I think it goes right back to the founding of the country. I mean, the Second Amendment's constant. People want to be free. You're not free unless you can own a firearm. There were bad people then, there are bad people now, and that's why the Chicago case, which is the NRA case that will probably end up before the Supreme Court, is so important. I mean, my gosh, I mean, when a criminal breaks down a door at 2 a.m. in the morning, Justice Sotomayor is not going to be there. It's the individual citizen and the criminal, and citizens know this instinctively. It's like water quenches your thirst. Food quenches your hunger. With a firearm, I can protect my family and save my family's life. And if Judge Sotomayor doesn't get that and believe the Second Amendment ought to apply to every citizen of the country, she should not be on the Supreme Court. This is a core fundamental freedom in the United States. We need to protect it. We don't need someone on the Supreme Court that's going to be slippery or evasive about it.